How's everybody doing this evening? Good. Well, getting started off right, I guess. So, I'm gonna play some songs. This is Chuck. How y'all doing? This is Kevin.
Hey y'all. How's it going?
They're gonna help me. They're gonna help me play some songs. I love the fact that I don't even have to say anything anymore. So I'm gonna play some songs. I might tell a couple stories depending on how much whiskey I drink, which chances are pretty good I'll drink enough whiskey to start telling stories. There's a really, really, really good chance that I might offend a few people. But if I offended you, it means I was trying to.
Let's go, Aaron!
So, one more disclaimer before we get going. I just want to let you know that I have absolutely no say over what songs I'm playing tonight. I didn't make my set list. Chuck did. So if you have any issues with the songs that I play or don't play tonight, because I can't play them all, it's Chuck's fault. So here's the first fucking winner that Chuck picked for you.
Out of this goodbye.
did my dive bar, I used to go. I gotta get out. I wanna let's get by. Wheels spinning around. I wanna let's get by. Everybody happy so far? Ain't worth a lot of money and a damn sure ain't You know, actually, the very jovial and quite southern gentleman that opened up for me this evening, Bobby Pinson, he wrote that song. You hear that, Chuck?
Thank you.
How you doing?
All it takes, though, is one song not getting played and they'll turn on me like that.
Is that what happened?
No.
Well, you know, Fetterman is proof that the Democrats could run a ham sandwich. I mean, one thing that they have is unity. They will stick together and vote in someone that has absolutely no business being there. Has anybody seen the polling map? Like that map that they show after everybody votes to show the entire country being red except for these little specks of blue.
Republicans are eliminating Democrats!
Yet somehow, with crime and living conditions and everything else is the worst in this country, they somehow put the Democrats back in. It is so hard to not see it and call it what it is at face value. It's called electronic cheating. I mean, how can we expect that our votes are going to get put into a computer and not be able to get fucked with? Why can't we just go back to paper ballots like we did for fucking all the way up until some of these brilliant ideas?
Hey, let's make this electronic.
And then, so make it electronic and then complain about it all the way up until it starts cheating for them, and then it's the most secure shit ever. Anyway. So this song has nothing to do with any of that. It's another Chuck choice for you. This is a good one.
I appreciate you, Chuck.
So this song pretty much told me that For the record that this song was on, it pretty much told me that I wasn't going to be capable of writing all the lyrics for it by myself, because it was going to rip me to shreds. So I wrote a lot of this record, except for this song, with other people to kind of dilute the personalness of it all. So I was sharing it. I was sharing that process with somebody else and bringing someone else into it, which made it feel a little bit less vulnerable for me.
Don't be a pussy.
Diet is a healthy part of fuck off. Alright, well, this song is for Vagina Boy back there. Yeah, this song is called Pull Me Under.
Me!
you honey in my dream. So far, Chuck.
Yeah, Chuck!
Good thing you picked all these songs tonight. We could have sucked. I don't know. I've heard you sing some pretty weird shit. Still not sucked. You get paid to say that. Tell us a story, Chuck. Actually, no, fuck that. I don't want one of your stories. Kevin?
Yes, sir.
Tell us a story.
Oh, my God. Well, this one time I was in Vegas. Yeah, it's one of those stories. I was at a bachelor party.
Wait, are you supposed to tell these stories?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I can.
What happens in Vegas?
Yeah, I can tell this.
Okay.
Yeah. This is what happens in Vegas. I'm telling you right now. It happened. This is real. There I was with my buddy Zach. And a couple other buddies.
Zach who?
He roofied a bunch of us. I don't know his last name. I can't pronounce it. It's a long last name.
Galifianakis?
So he roofied us. And then we are in Vegas. We don't know what we're doing. We can't remember crap. And here we are. We steal a tiger. I lose a tooth. I had to fight Mike Tyson at one point. And I married a hooker. With a heart of gold. Oh, wait.
Wait a minute. That sounds familiar.
Oh, God. I'm sorry, you guys. I just pulled a Joe Biden. I just confused reality with fantasy. Oh, my God.
Y'all deserve better than that. I apologize. That's a terrible story. You okay?
I just pulled a Fetterman out of my mind.
Well, all right. That was a little Fetterman-ish.
You didn't shoot yourself, did you?
Not this time.
Do you think Fetterman shits himself like Biden does?
Definitely.
Boy, right?
Well, it depends. I mean,
it depends, really. I can't read.
Please say
happy birthday.
Hey.
I like your hat.
Oh, thank you.
It says natural immunity on it.
Yeah. I didn't take that stupid shot. That they forced on our military.
Yeah. Nobody got a job for not taking it.
I did. Well, true. I can't really talk about that.
Because I hired him. I hired him because I found out that he got fired because he wouldn't take the shot. So I was like, well, I'm hiring that motherfucker because he wouldn't take the shot.
High five.
Long distance. And Chuck, nobody would give him the shot. They wanted him to
take COVID. They wanted the off.
Poor Chuck. You are.
Yeah.
Go get yourself a whiskey and come back. And every time I pick my cup up, just time it. And you'll be drinking whiskey with me. It's. Here you go. Here's an opportunity. Ready? What's what? Yeah, what's your deal?
I'm drinking LaCroix. I got sober almost 2 years ago. Which is good news for the rest of the guys, because now there's actually vodka for them on the bus.
I could tell you. There's a lot of reasons that Chuck doesn't drink anymore. He's looking at me like, dude. Alright. So as I said about the song before, it was the song when I was called so nicely called a pussy by a person in this audience who paid for a ticket to come see me tonight.
He's right here.
So that song fucked me up, and I didn't want to write any more songs by myself. So this next song I wrote with David Lee Murphy. Might be a little dust on the bottle. Yeah, that guy. And we sat down in my living room and we wrote this bitch. It's called Again.
Thank you. Not clever in face value. It's about self-created prisons.
We would get in really bad trouble.
You know about those? I do. I've talked to enough therapists.
My time. No jury ever made. Still paying this price for the life I chose. Once you're not a record, guess it's how it goes. Still serving my sentence with a soul guitar. Spending my time living life behind bars. Spending my time living life behind bars.
You pay attention, that shit ain't nothing about going to jail at all. Fuck, that tastes good. Why does it taste so good? He must have put some Tussin in it.
Nutshell.
Fucker. We yell that at Alice in Chains. So this song came from... it probably came from this motherfucker running late to get to my house. Because the writing session was at my house that day. And he was late as fuck. And we were all sitting there waiting for him. And I think he had it planned. So it was like a big, impactful moment. But it worked out that way, whether it was God or whether it was him scheming. I doubt it was him scheming, it was probably God. But he comes bursting through my door after being stuck in traffic, which would have caused him to have the moment to have this very profound thought and phrase for this whole song to be built off of. And he comes bursting through my door after his apologies for being late. He's like, I got a song idea. He's like, I think it could be great. I'm like, well, what is it? Kill me like you love me. And I was like, wow, that's pretty profound and deep, brother. And I looked at him and I said, just tell me that you're sorry when you're done. And he said, wow, that's pretty profound and deep, brother. And we sat down and in a half an hour we had this song. That's just how it happens. All it takes is one phrase. I could have heard you say it in passing as I was eavesdropping on you as you walked by. We all do that, right? People watching is like the funnest thing ever. And then you do like the Astro Creek 3000 thing and you add like dialogue. What you're seeing, it's so fun. If you've never played that, you're not living life. Smashes. So I'm realizing I didn't eat dinner tonight. So this is better for you, really. It's gonna be a fun show from here on out. Cause I'm not smart enough to go, oh shit, I didn't eat, so I should probably slow down on the drinking. No. It just means I'm gonna get to that point of telling stories.
You actually like that?
I promise I'll still play the same amount of songs. Yeah. Kill me like you love me.
Kill me like you love me. Just tell me that you're sorry.
You keep yelling nutshell, I'm gonna have the person next to you punch you right in the mouth. Careful. So, this song just screams, I don't give a fuck. It's for Vagina Boy again back there. Yeah. You dummy.
Don't you think?
It's like having a deer on your wall and being like, you know what? It's just not big and juicy enough. I'm gonna remount that motherfucker. And make him thicker and fuller. Have you seen that guy doing the Nancy Pelosi rap? Boom! It's fucking greatness. Did I send that to you?
No.
I gotta send that to you.
No, I like
to. So I guess that Nancy's fake tits really didn't do anything for Paul. It seems he likes guys that are nudists that break into his house in their underwear with a hammer hidden somewhere. Which is really strange, because if he broke in, why is the window broken from the inside out? And why was there Astroglide all over the hammer?
We don't know that.
Listen, that might be my coloration.
I mean, we know.
It's a theory. It's a game. It's a new game that they play. It's called Hammer, Hammer, Who's Got the Hammer? Listen, fuck that. Fuck that. That old man likes some fucked up, weird, kinky, fucked up shit. And I personally think that he should just own it, because it's his freedom to do so. And we should send DePappy back to Canada, because he's a fucking illegal alien. Most definitely a Canadian that has overstayed his visa, stated by all of the news sources, even the fake ones.
If you keep walking,
I dressed up like Paul Pelosi for Halloween just for my dogs. They didn't appreciate it at all. They're Frenchies, so they have an attitude. And they looked at me like, Dad, what are you doing? Even they found it fucked up. This is why they love me. The left. They fucking love me. You know what I've noticed, though? I've noticed that they don't put me on blast as much as they used to.
It's probably because every time they put me... Oh. They stopped putting me on blast because they realized very quickly that every time they put me on blast, it fucking blew up and it backfired on them. Because everybody was like, fuck. That shit's true. All you have to do is look at the video clip that goes along with the hit piece, and you're like, wait a minute, that's not what he fucking said at all.
Let's go, Dallas!
So, I'll shut up now.
Everybody talks tonight. was doing pretty good on the song selection tonight, right?
So this is a heavy moment every night for me anyways. Because I just get the honor and the privilege of playing this song every night. Because I didn't write it. A medic in our military wrote this song. This is one of those songs that you had to live it to write it. And we should all consider ourselves very blessed and lucky that we didn't have to live it.
Red blood on my hands,
Nobody called me hero except my old man. They call me Doc. Chuck, motherfuckers. This is an edit. Why does whiskey taste so good? Even though it tastes like bad decisions. Motherfucker.
Full of pride.
You're ugly like me. I can see through you, see to the real
songs they all play.
sell a million records, boy. Better listen to me. So change your style, widen your smile. Even with a couple of pounds, if you wanna live this life, you better lose that wife. Do you need your friends around? I said, shit, that's not me. 'Cause the biggest things in life are your friends and family. And I like my jeans and my old t-shirts. Couple extra pounds never really hurt. You're a country boy, all I'll ever be. 'Cause Hank taught me just how to stay alive. Never catch me out the house without my 9 or 45. I got a big old tractor and a diesel truck. My idea of heaven's chasing whitetail bucks. And as a country boy, I know I can survive.
We all still good?
Well, good.
So, I guess Chuck has a story for you. He expressed to me when we walked off stage that he was very hurt by the fact that I stole his story from him and I gave it to Kevin. I just thought you'd be proud of me for this one. So, my wife and I are living in an apartment house hunting, and after several years, our... Hey!
The man...
Man's trying to tell a story over here. The manager of our apartment complex sent us an email Tuesday afternoon expressing that we had to take our American flag off of our porch. So me being the quick thinker that I am, it was very clear the email said from the exterior of the porch, so now my wife and I have two American flags hanging on the inside of our windows with LED lights shining brightly upon them so everybody can see them.
Makes me smile.
All right, so I'm gonna start this next little section here with a new song that I have not recorded yet.
Hold on.
Hey. Give me some grace. I've been drinking. Has anybody else noticed that pretty much everything that we buy, if you take the time to look on the back of the box, it says made in China? Bill Clinton sold us out to China, people. Well, I'll tell you one thing that ain't made in fucking China here in America. Fucking me. Wrote a song about it. Wanna hear it? Here it go. Well, I ain't made in China. Come on, Jesus Christ. And I them imported foreign cars. I'm more like American muscle from 1966. Yeah, I ain't made in China, 'cause I'm American as it free.
I'm proud of where I'm from. For in Manor City raised, I'm proud to say I'm neither. And I ain't selling on many of mine, and I ain't buying theirs either. If you got something to say about that, well, you can suck my dick.
Cigarettes, they fucking go out on you constantly. Go figure. A cigarette is supposed to be like a joint, where if you stop paying attention to it for a second, it actually goes out.
secret, I can say it. I get it wrong most of the time. But looking at you right now, baby, you're the one thing I got right. Guess I must have found an angel sent from heaven's gold. Someone else would have walked away. Someone else would have never stayed. Chance how someone else would have left me alone. Thank you.
It's all projection. You know what that is, right?
That's like fucking psychology 101. Projection is when you push upon the person that you're talking to that of which you are guilty of. So, really, all you gotta do is listen to them. They'll tell you. They are unafraid of telling you. They are so unbelievably out in the open at this point. All you have to do is flip it. If they're saying that we are responsible for it, know in your hearts that they are responsible for it. From slavery all the way through to CRT and all this gender bullshit. Why can't I hold on to a goddamn cigarette? All the way up to today, people, don't be distracted by these stupid things. I better put it in my mouth before I drop it again. That's all I wanted to do the whole time. Everything from owning all the slaves to trying to turn our kids against us. They are 100% responsible for all of it. See, you kind of clap like you're unsure. It is historical fact that the Democrats owned every fucking slave. It is historical fucking fact that the Democrats started every KKK movement. It is historical fact that they voted and put into place every segregational law, every Jim Crow law that they now say that we're responsible for. Fuck that shit. They did it all. They did it all. How we allow the Democratic Party to have any control in the United States of America is fucking beyond me. These people, that party, is responsible for every atrocity to have ever taken place in the United States of America. Look it the fuck up yourself. The last thing in the world I want you to do, like everybody else, is believe me. I want you to go and look for yourself. Go familiarize yourself with the Constitution. You ever think of doing that? Like really being able to fire off shit off the Constitution to the person that's trying to argue with you? It's what all of these motherfuckers that are destroying our country right now, they swore to uphold and defend the Constitution. The Constitution is what sets us free, people. The Constitution is the rule book. It's the rule book for the government. There's this thing called 18 enumerated powers. It is the only 18 things that the federal government is allowed to do. Everything else is supposed to be a state and local thing. The federal government is just there to oversee. That's it. That's it. We do not live in a fucking democracy, people. We live in a fucking republic. And to
the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for every motherfucker that's lucky enough to be here. Make sure you tip your bartenders and your waitresses.
Singing along every time they play a
God bless America.